Hi guys, welcome to my channel. This is your girl Abby. I am starting this new YouTube channel for entrepreneurs, business people, go-getters, stuff. In this video, we're gonna be talking about the four P's to market it. I have all my notes in my handy dandy velvet notebook. Like, look how cute this is. So freaking adorable. I'm sorry. Please excuse the nails, the hair, the eyebrows. It is quarantine time and we are looking a hot mess. A little bit about myself. I just graduated from college with my bachelor's degree in hospitality management and currently getting a master's in it because that's just what I do. I just repeat the same degree. It's fine. And then I got a minor in entrepreneurship and I was like, whoa, 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 Abby, what is going on? And I loved it. Took all of the notes in the world, saved it, and then I was like, you know what? Let me let everybody know what these notes are, because, you know, there's people out there that are noteless, and I'm noteful, so I feel like we need to equate. So the first P of marketing is the product. Now, when you are looking into marketing something or selling something, a service, an item, tangible, intangible, yada, yada, you need to make sure it speaks to your audience. You need to make sure that you have some type of value proposition. Now, I will be making a whole video on value proposition because one of my favorite professors, Pepe, told me, and he used to agitate me every single time that I would tell him my value proposition. He was like, no, what is your real value proposition? I'm like, Pepe, I just told you what it was. So it's not my fault you don't listen. My team realized that. No. That is not the value proposition. That is just a lie you tell yourself. Quick definition of what a value proposition is. What do you bring to the client that is different from your other competitors? You know, some people might call this a competitive advantage. Some people might call this, you know, what makes you unique, your little spunk, your little twist. Either way, you need to have something and you need to make sure it's strong. Because if it's not strong, then you'll get overlooked for either something, a brand or a company that's much bigger than you, or a company that offers the same service in your same market but is more defined. Once you understand what your product is, after doing a lot of research, a lot of like survey gathering and all that stuff, kind of like observing your targeted audience, making sure they actually want this product or service, you want to look at the price. Now, price is something that is very special to each company, each business. You won't get it on the first try. I can tell you that right now, you will not get on the first try. You know, you might think it's too much, you might think it's too little, and it all depends on your audience. If your audience sees a product, for example, this picture frame that might have or might not have me. So if this audience says, wow, this picture frame is worth a dollar because I got it for a dollar at the Dollar Tree. This picture frame is worth a dollar and I'm only gonna pay for a dollar for it. If you're charging $10 for the same picture frame, a lot of clients or a lot of customers are not gonna probably buy this picture frame because the quality is only worth a dollar and there's really no significance to why they should pay $9 extra for something they could get someplace else for only a dollar. Now, let's say this is $5 and I sell it for 50 cents, but everywhere else says, you know, items like this are $5. People might seem like, well, why? What is up with this product that I am only paying 50 cents for? Paying the price game is, you know, fun and dandy at times, but it's not a sustainable environment to be in, to always be either the cheapest thing or only the company that's always on discounts, because customers are not going to purchase your items full priced. If I know that this framing company is always gonna have a discount after 5 days of them releasing a new product, I'm not gonna buy this product once they release it, because I know that they're gonna make it 50% off in a couple days. Understanding how much your customers are gonna pay for your products or your services, making sure you're confident, saying, yes, I know that this is gonna be $9 more than what you guys are used to paying, but there's a story behind this picture frame, or this quality of this picture frame is much, much better than the ones that you get at the Dollar Tree. Next page. After You find your product, you find your price for your product. Next thing is promotion. Now we need to find, you know, you need to figure out how your clients are gonna get to your product. How are they gonna know that you're having a sale? How are they gonna know about this product? You know, where are they gonna go? So it all depends on your targeted audience, how they usually get information, especially during this whole quarantine time. Everybody's on their social media. So targeted ads through social media is a really good idea when it comes to products and services right now. A couple outlets that you could think of are email lists. Those are really strong, especially for customer loyal programs, Instagram, Facebook. And since Instagram and Facebook are linked, because Facebook, I believe, bought out Instagram, you could do your ads from Facebook and they go straight to Instagram and Facebook. It's just beautiful. You could also do TikTok. I see a lot of companies starting to post on their TikTok, how they make things, how they sell stuff. And then YouTube, kind of what I'm doing right now. Hopefully I can open my business and kind of show you guys behind the scenes of what I will be doing and all that stuff. Once you get your outlet, then that's the place that you will be broadcasting your promotion. You want to make sure your audience is where you're promoting. If you know that your audience is mainly older, you know, boomer age, middle age people, you know, late millennials, you know, stuff like that, then Instagram might not be the place for you. Facebook might be the place for you to post your ads. Once you have your product, your price, and your promotion, you need a place. Now, the place in general and usual aspects is a location, a physical location. So if you're opening a shop, you need to make sure your targeted audience is in that location, if not close. Now, since a lot of people are doing things that are online, me included, it's probably best that your website is user-friendly, as well as how long is it going to take for your products to get to their house. Because now it's not only can I drive to your place, but now it's turning into how fast can you get your stuff to me at Amazon. If Nordstrom has some cute heels, it's free shipping, but it's gonna take a week. But Amazon has similar shoes, same price, if not a little bit more, but I get 2-day shipping. I'm probably gonna choose the 2-day shipping because A, I probably need that pair of heels for this outfit. We have your product, price, promotion, and place. Now I'm gonna do a little like story time. Let's say you have a clothing line. Value proposition in your clothing line is that you cater to women that have long arms. The dresses, the long sleeve, the jackets, everything has like 2 inches extra of fabric. That is one, your value proposition, and two, your product in general. Second is the price. Now there's a whole bunch of ways you could price things, yada yada. Let's say you get the product, or the wholesale price is $5 per sweater, and you see a lot of similar products for $20. Let's say I buy it for $5 and then I see everybody selling them for 15 to 20. I'm making already a $15 markup. We have the product, which are the dresses, the long sleeves for lengthy women's long Lisas, as I like to call them. Well, myself. The price is gonna be $20 for a sweater. And the promotion, I'm going to promote it on Instagram because that's where I see a lot of my targeted market. My targeted market, let's say, are 25-year-old, newly fresh out of college, just got a job, starting to spend some more cash. These girls are going to be comfortable spending $20 on a sweater. I'm probably gonna show this on Instagram through a short video, showing people the day in the life of it, how you can style it. These are all ideas for promotional videos because videos speak much, much more volume than photos. And then the place, I'm gonna have it on my online store, and my processing is gonna only be 3 days, and shipping's gonna be from so-and-so to so-and-so amount of days, depending on where you live. Those are the 4 P's of marketing. I hope that helped you guys in any way. If you guys have any other business ideas or any other ideas in general that you guys wanna see from me, put it in the comments below. Make sure you guys like and subscribe, and I will see you guys next time. Bye.